News review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we bring you the language you need to talk about the news. I'm Finn and I'm joined by Neil. Hi, Neil.
Hi there, Finn.
Tell us about today's story.
Okay, we've got a story here about large numbers of people moving from one place to another. That's called migration. And the story is based in France.
Okay, so let's find out a bit more about this story with this World Service news report.
BBC News with Neil Nunes. Demolition teams are due to return to the French port of Calais shortly to dismantle more makeshift shelters in the migrant camp known as the jungle. During the night, there were clashes between police and migrants trying to reach Britain.
So this is a story from Calais on the north coast of France, where a migrant camp known as the jungle is being cleared by the French authorities. Now, this has led to violence and conflict between the police and migrants who were staying there. They wanted to, or they were hoping to, travel to Britain.
Indeed. So this is a big story. There's a lot of coverage of this story. And I know, Neil, you've been looking at some of the language that's been used by different news sites. What language have you picked out for us today?
Yes, I've been looking around and there are three words and expressions I think are useful for talking about this story. They are evict, braced for, and bulldozer.
Okay, so let me define those three expressions. To evict someone is to force someone to leave a place. When you're braced for something, you are ready for it, and it's normally something bad. And finally, a bulldozer is a large, heavy vehicle with a big metal curved panel at the front, which is used to push stones and earth. That's a bulldozer. Neil, so tell us, how are these words and expressions appearing in news headlines?
Okay, so we've got the Telegraph here, and the headline is Calais Jungle, Migrants Set Tents on Fire as Riot Police Attempt to Evict Them. So there it is, the verb to evict.
To evict.
And we have a slightly different version of the word here in the Independent. Calais Jungle evictions. Demolition teams and riot police return to refugee camp after tear gas fired overnight. So in the first headline, we had to evict, the verb. And here we have, as a plural noun, evictions.
To evict. Evictions. Now, Neil, tell us, how is this word normally used?
Well, in everyday usage, you would probably hear this most if, for example, your landlord, that's the person who owns your accommodation, was trying to get you out of that accommodation. You may have done something wrong or not, but...
Are you saying I've done something wrong?
Say, for example, Finn, that you hadn't paid your rent.
Yes.
Or that you were horribly antisocial and you played loud music late at night.
Nothing like me.
Upsetting all of your neighbours.
Yeah.
Then your landlord may try to evict you. That's to throw you out of your accommodation.
That sounds impossible, Neil, but a very good illustration of the term. Mm. Now, let us look at the next one, braced for.
Yeah, so here we have in Huffington Post, Calais Jungle braced for a second round of demolition as fights between police and migrants break out. And in the Telegraph here, Calais Jungle braced for more trouble as bulldozers and riot police resume clearance. So braced for, as you explained earlier, preparing yourself for a force of some kind.
Mm.
It might be the weather, strong winds. You could hold onto a pole and put your legs wide.
A big storm.
That's right. Brace yourself so it doesn't blow you over.
Okay.
But we use it figuratively as well, as it is here. Braced for something powerful. Bulldozers, eviction, exam results, something that has some kind of power in your life.
Or a negative thing, like bad news.
Yeah.
You could brace yourself because you're expecting to hear something bad.
That's right.
And finally, I think in that last headline, we heard the word bulldozer, didn't we?
Yeah, so I'll read the headline again from the Telegraph here. Calais Jungle braced for more trouble as bulldozers and riot police resume clearance. And that word bulldozers here. Also in Euronews, more confrontations at Calais migrant camp after bulldozers move in. And as you explained,
Yeah, bulldozer is a big, it's a big heavy vehicle used to push stones and earth. So that's it as a noun in its normal usage. Neil, tell us.
Can be used as a verb as well.
Yes, tell us about
this. This means to force your point of view or opinion through when there's might be some kind of opposition to it. So I could be in a meeting. Nobody agrees with me. Everybody else has got a different opinion.
I can't imagine this, Neil.
And I bulldoze through the meeting. It's just I force my way through, and anybody else's opinion I consider just to be rubbish that can be pushed away.
Neil, that's so unlike you.
I don't know what you're saying.
But forcing yourself through meetings, I can't imagine that at all.
Don't know what you mean.
Very good. So that's to bulldoze, which means to force your idea through. You can also use it, let's imagine there's a huge crowd of people. You're here, you want to get to the door over there, you bulldoze your way through the crowd.
Yeah, onto the tube or train or whatever.
Right, so let's get back to today's news story. And we have a bit more background from the BBC's Anna Holligan, who is in Calais here with this report.
Hidden by the cover of darkness, groups of migrants try to access trucks on the motorway heading to the port of Calais. Riot police fired tear gas, forcing them back. Yesterday, the demolition squads moved through the jungle. Some migrants and protesters threw rocks in an effort to delay their eviction. The government is trying to encourage people to relocate to alternative accommodation provided inside converted shipping containers nearby. But most have refused the offer, fearing they'll be forced to claim asylum in France.
So that was the BBC's Anna Holligan from Calais. And if you listened carefully, she used the word eviction in there, which was one of today's words. Now, it's time to look at today's challenge. We asked you on Facebook a question about nouns that can become verbs. We said, did you know that you can use the word microwave as a verb? You can microwave something. You can microwave your dinner. And then we asked, which of these nouns can we not use as a verb? Okay, so we said A, bulldozer, B, hammer, and C, keyboard. Okay, so I think those of you who are listening carefully just now might know the bit about the bulldozer. But what about the other two? Neil, tell us, what kind of response have we got on Facebook?
We had a big response.
Very nice.
We had a variety of answers, some right and some wrong. I'll read some of them out. Sandra Tejera says, maybe B, hammer. What do you think about that, Finn?
I think that's wrong, but let's listen to another person.
Well, we have here Ibrahim Hagras, who says keyboard is the word that we cannot use as a verb.
And I think that's absolutely correct. So well done.
That's right, yes. And another person who got that one right, Omar Abdu Al-Aziz, says, I think keyboard we can't use as a verb. Mm. And although you might think to keyboard means to write on a keyboard, we don't actually use that.
We can't use keyboard as a verb unless today, right here and right now, Neil, we declare that keyboard can be a verb.
Let's invent a word.
Let's do this. I'm going to go after this program and keyboard a few things.
You should do that. One more little point here we've got from Yash Diniz. Well, someone can be hammered.
Mm. Ah, now that's a good one.
Right.
You can be hammered. Actually using it as an adjective there.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
A couple of meanings here. Uh-huh. The first one, hammered means defeated heavily.
Oh.
So for example, you could say Andy Murray was hammered by Novak Djokovic.
Yes.
In whatever final it was recently, in which he was hammered.
It does happen
beaten
sometimes,
very,
yes.
Beaten heavily.
Yeah.
And it can also mean, Finn, drunk.
So Andy Murray.
Andy Murray.
Not Andy Murray this time.
If you can describe somebody who's very, very drunk as hammered.
Yes. A description we could never, ever apply to ourselves, Neil.
Absolutely not.
Absolutely not. We're not hammered, neither are we. Keyboarded or bulldozed. But those are today's words. Thank you very much, everyone, for taking part on Facebook. And Neil, can we now ask you to summarize the language we've been looking at today?
So a quick summary, we heard